ladies and gentlemen, Doug Page along with you here on the Pioneer Sports Network, following the Pioneers' big season opening victory 12-5 against the Indianapolis Greyhounds. And Coach Brandon Steele, obviously a big win starting off the 2021 season. Just talk about getting back out in the field and getting a victory and just really just getting back to playing.
I mean, obviously there's a lot of anticipation leading up to us finally having the chance to play almost 11 months removed from the end of our season last year. And I think I personally had a big sigh after the first pitch, just that we were able to navigate all the challenges this year to get to the point that we have the opportunity to play. And then obviously a quality opponent against Indianapolis that was 12-3 last year, and the team that typically goes in postseason. So having them in, we knew coming into this weekend that we have to play some pretty good baseball, have a chance to be competitive with them. And it really started on the mound for us today with Gunnar Becker and what he was able to do. And not only what he was able to do as far as keeping them off the board, but what he's able to do as far as saving our bullpen tomorrow. Because tomorrow's going to be a long day having some 9-inning games tomorrow.
And you talked about breathing that sigh of relief after the first pitch, and he comes out, gives you 7 quality innings, strikes out 8 batters, and really did limit, outside of getting those 3 hits in the one inning, really did limit their offensive output. So talk about that from just a confidence standpoint, not only what it does for the defense, but what it does from the offense standpoint, getting that type of performance to open up the season.
Well, we know he's a very, very competitive young man, and when he's on, he's really, really good. And even when he's not, he's still going to give us enough to give us a chance to win just through sheer will. And the way he was able to locate and change speeds today and keep them off balance, and let's be honest, it's the first game of the year for both our teams. And, you know, offensively, we're not in full stride yet, which I think Indianapolis will be really good for the team. But he was able to capitalize a little bit on some teams like ourselves and them being limited on the number of scrimmages they've had. And he really just kept on minimizing the pitch count through inning, which allowed us to get, really, I thought we were going to get 5 out of it today. And the fact that we didn't get 7 was huge.
And you're back in the offensive side of things, 12 runs, added some late in that 8th inning. But talk about the base running. That looks like some pretty aggressive base running. That put some very good situations, especially late in that game. So just talk about that aspect of the game and what you guys were able to do in the base pad when getting runners on there.
Yeah, Bryson Ford was able to ball out, steal a base early. And then I thought we did pretty good as far as taking the extra base when the ball play. And we had a couple good rear ball reads that allowed us to have guys in the 90-foot range scoring. And situational hitting-wise, I think we can still improve in that area, but I think we did a pretty good job today as far as driving guys in from third with less than 2 out and capitalizing the opportunities that we did receive from the mistakes that they made with hit-by-pitch walkers or whatever it may be.
So 2 games tomorrow, obviously against the Greyhounds. Just kind of talk about what maybe some of the goals are going into that doubleheader tomorrow and kind of wrapping up that first weekend of the season.
Well, just to continue to play better baseball each time out. I thought today we did a fair job as far as situation hitting. I think we can still elevate our execution level as far as making sure we're getting guys there for second and third. Pitching-wise, I think we can be a little bit more efficient on the mound as far as our pitch counts per inning. And, you know, if you look at Parker, for example, he pitched pretty darn good if you look at his stuff. But, you know, if you look at the scoreboard, the box score, it doesn't reflect that. He got to 2 strikes. He was able to throw strikes. So if we can get him, you know, to finish some guys off, the same with Alec Clay. Alec just let a couple pitches up. We got ahead of the counts a couple times, so we have to do a better job of finishing to close out innings and really minimize, you know, the stress of our bullpen over the course of really a 4-game weekend next weekend.
Thank you for joining me, Coach. You can find your head coach, Brandon Steele. He joins us here in the postgame show as the Pioneers pick up the big win to start out the 2021 season. A pair of games tomorrow here at Pioneer Park against Indianapolis. We thank you for tuning in. Again, follow along with Pioneers at TusculumPioneers.com.